This is a Novartis symposium on sickle cell disease. I'm going to present sickle cell disease and highlights on Egypt. This is my disclosure, and this is the outline of my presentation. Actually, sickle hemoglobin results from a substitution of one amino acid valine for another amino acid glutamic acid. The end result, an abnormal amino acid in the globin chain, hemoglobin S will constitute. This will form long insoluble monomers when deoxygenated, and the red blood cells containing hemoglobin S become less deformable and form sickle cell. This is showing you the diagram showing you the hemoglobin, the RBCs, and when the RBCs containing hemoglobin S deoxygenated, usually in the small vessels, this will take the sickle shape. Sickle shape inside the blood vessel is going to entangle together, act with the venous walls, and forming occlusion of these vessels. What is the net result of this is ischemia, leading to necrosis, organ dysfunction, acute pain, and oxygen perfusion stress. On another hand, this will cause hemolysis of the RBCs with fatigue, anemia, cholelithiasis, and endothelial dysfunction. The hemolysis will release hemoglobin in the plasma, leading to excretion of nitrous oxide with the decrease of nitrous oxide and the subsequent pathophysiology. What about the symptoms of sickle cell anemia? This anemia, why? The half-life of the sickle cell is too short, 10 to 20 days. There's episodes of pain, chest, abdomen, joints, bones. The pain varies in intensity and can last for a few hours to a few weeks. This painful swelling of the hand and feet, what is called hand and feet syndrome. And this is, as well, there's frequent infections. Infants and children with sickle cell anemia, vaccinations is important, and antibiotics to prevent potentially life-threatening infections. There is delayed growth. There is vision problems due to affection of the retinal vessels in these patients. What is the complications of sickle cell disease? There is organ damage. Sickle cells block blood flow, as I said before, leading to chronic deprivation of oxygen-rich blood, which damages nerves and organs in the body, including kidney, liver, and spleen. Organ damage can be actually fatal. And this are group of our patients with sickle cell disease, with hand syndrome, as you see down, and severe pallor, some of them retarded growth. The one on the right side is a sickle beta thalassemia, where we can find a spleen and liver. Usually, sickle cell patients has no spleen from repeated infarction and fibrosis, and disappearance of the spleen. As well, complication stroke, which is very important and very hazard for the patient. Block of blood flow to an area of brain. Signs include seizures, weakness or numbness of arms and legs. Sudden speech difficulties, and this is one of the complaints which the mother can come with it. And loss of consciousness sometimes. And stroke can be fatal. Pulmonary hypertension, this is usually more seen in adults. It usually affects adults rather than children. There is shortness of breath, fatigue are common symptoms of this complication. Acute chest syndrome, chest pain, fever, and difficulty breathing. It can be caused by a lung infection or by sickle cells blocking blood vessels in the lungs. It might require emergency medical treatment with antibiotics and other treatment. As well, due to affection of the retinal vessels, we may have blindness, we have leg ulcers, we may have gallstones, and we have priapism, which is a painful erection of the penis in children, and as well can occur in adults. Sickle cell, what about sickle cell in Egypt? In our hematology clinic of Calvin University Abu Rish Hospital, we have got around 746 cases. Most of them are sickle beta thalassemia and 215 are sickle cell anemia, and sickle beta thalassemia are less than the sickler patients. And most of these sicklers, from where they are coming? They are coming from the oocysts. Siwa oocysts has got a very high carrier rate, which amounts up to 22.1%, which is very high. Siwa oocysts with sickle cell disease actually dates back at least to the time of Ramses III, when it is populated by the Egyptian pharaohs. But the coming of Islam in Egypt, Arab tribes settled in Siwa and increases the carrier of sickle cell diseases. As well, in the Western Desert, Al-Kharga and Al-Dakhla, this increase as well, carrier rate mounts up to 9%. This population has got very interesting and fantastic customs. They are dressing like this, as you see. They are putting on the left side, these are the females, putting all these dresses, covering all their body and covering as well their face. And this is, we went there in a trip to the Siwa, where we have been with Dr. Mona Taghi and Dr. Mona Gamrawi and other colleagues, young colleagues, young generation, where we visit them and see them on life. They were very interesting and very aware of the problem of sickle, but they have no sufficient support for treatment of these patients. What about the genetic basis of genotype in Egypt? The most common is the Benin type. This is most common among the Egyptian patients, mounting up to 63%. What about the common presentation of our cases with sickle cell disease in our hematology clinic? They are most common coming with bone crisis and disappearance of the spleen or spleen crisis with a severe pain before the disappearance of the spleen. But chest and cerebral are existed but are less common. What about our management of the cases? When we give blood transfusion for these patients, this either infrequent or frequent 12 times per year. We can give regularly, every 3 to 4 weeks, if there's frequent crisis and if there is chest or cerebral crisis. When we do exchange transfusion, we do it when there is acute chest syndrome, where there is cerebral vascular occlusion, and where is severe bony crisis. We do exchange transfusion. What about the cases, other cases and management? In our team, we give folic acid, and this is as well thing in the insurance as well, and all over Egypt as well. Folic acid, L-carnitine, piracetam, vitamin D, hydroxyurea, and we do regularly every 6 months or 1 year transcranial Doppler. What is the function of this for the cases of sickle cell anemia? For L-carnitine, L-carnitine is an aminobutyric acid derivative present in all tissues and acts as an essential cofactor for influxing of long-chain fatty acid and energy production. We did a study, so it is long ago, for the diastolic function and pulmonary hypertension, sickle cell anemia, by using L-carnitine. And we found, as you see in this table, there is improvement of this patient in every parameter, in weight, in height, in decrease in the amount of blood they are receiving, number of vaso-occlusive from 1.2 to nothing, serum ferritin starts to decrease as well, hemoglobin starts to increase as well. What about the pulmonary blood pressure? The pulmonary blood pressure is, you look down to the next line, pulmonary systolic pressure, well, in 17 cases it was high systolic blood pressure, it was 40, goes down to 32 within normal, with big value, very statistically significant. L-carnitine, not only us, not only Egypt, not only our center, L-carnitine caused a significant reduction in pulmonary artery and pulmonary wedge pressures in patients with congestive heart failure. This is published by Rizos long ago. For piracetam, why are you using piracetam in these patients? This piracetam improves erythrocyte membrane deformability, so it decreases the deformability of the RBCs, reduce abnormal adhesion to endothelial surfaces, so reduce the occlusion of the vessels by this drug. Antiplatelet effect, you know that there is meninging of the sickle cell with the platelets with the white cells to occlude these vessels and causes the severe manifestations of sickle cell disease. As well, it has an antiplatelet effect. It shortens the mean intrasplenic red cell transient time in patients with SS or sickle beta thalassemia. The optimal dose for the prevention of the crisis, 160 milligram per kilogram in 4 divided dose orally. During the crisis, you can give it a higher dose, up to 300 milligram per kilogram intravenously, divided every 8 hours. And this is the Akosharan collaboration, which published on piracetam. Piracetam for reducing the incidence of painful sickle cell disease crisis. Piracetam have shown that it hinders the bonding of sickle hemoglobin and the bunching together of platelets. What about vitamin D? Is it vitamin D is important for cases of sickle cell disease? Yes, there has been a study, as you see here, which has been done in 2018, showed that vitamin D decreases the morbidity and decreases as well the respiratory affection among these cases. So it is important to give vitamin D for patients with sickle cell disease. We come to the important issue, which there is many debate in the Egyptian in this issue, hydroxyurea therapy. As well, this is in 2017 published, and before that, long ago, in the 90s, they were talking about hydroxyurea in sickle cell disease. The only drug currently approved by US FDA for the treatment of sickle cell disease. Frequent and severe pain. Long-term hydroxyurea is currently accepted treatment. Increases total and fetal hemoglobin. It increases total and fetal hemoglobin. It reduces the level of circulating leukocytes and decreases of adherence of neutrophils to the vascular endothelium. So it will decrease the obstruction of the vessels by the sickle cells. And this is showing you the effect of hydroxyurea in every part. The hydroxyurea for the hemolysis, affection, for vaso-occlusion decreases, for endothelial dysfunction, it decreases all this dysfunction which can be seen in sickle cell disease and cause all the symptoms of the sickle cell disease. And this is showing you the reduced cellularity, increased proportion of enucleated red cells producing hemoglobin F before and after giving hydroxyurea. As well, the increased hemoglobin F macrocytosis increases hydration, fewer sickle cell, fewer reticulocytes, and fewer granulocytes after receiving the hydroxyurea in the lower photo. And as well, the reduced adherence improved endothelial function by the use of hydroxyurea. Where is the indication when we indicate hydroxyurea? Well, there's frequent painful episodes, 6 or more per year, history of acute chest syndrome, history of other severe vaso-occlusive events, severe symptomatic anemia, severe unremitting chronic pain that cannot be controlled with conservative measures, history of stroke or a high risk for stroke. We come to a very important issue in sickle cell disease, which is CNS vasculopathy. CNS vasculopathy, or cerebral vascular complications, can give acute stroke, transient ischemic attacks, neurocognitive function. And this is very common to hear from the mother that the patient is not well tolerating well education, cannot understand well. Silence, there may be silent stroke with no clinical manifestations. Prevalence, about 4% in homozygous sickle cell disease, incidence highest in the first decade of life. Transcranial Doppler imaging, which we are using in our clinic and as well in many clinics for treating sickle cell disease, this is give a good indication where these patients are going to have stroke, occlusion of the cerebral vessels or not. Blood flow indicators, if it is more than 170 centimeter per second, there is a cutoff stroke indicator. If it is more than 200 centimeter per second, there is high stroke recurrence. If it is absent, what is this? There is total occlusion of the vessel. Transcranial echo Doppler and impact of hydroxyurea. This is an international trial conducted on 38 children with sickle cell disease, found that hydroxyurea treatment can lower elevated cerebral blood flow velocities, which have been linked to stroke risk. Maintenance of the sickle patients after blood transfusion, frequent blood transfusion, and going to hydroxyurea have been done in a big trial, international trial, which give a good idea that after a long use of 1 year use of blood transfusion, we can resort back to hydroxyurea and it gives a good result. And this is very important issue which everybody and every doctor is looking for. Higher hydroxyurea dose does no harm in sub-Saharan African children with sickle cell disease. And they did a study for the sperms without taking hydroxyurea and with hydroxyurea, and at the end they found no change. Hydroxyurea doesn't do anything in this issue in children or in adults. Effect of hydroxyurea exposure after puberty on sperm parameters in males and sickle cell disease has got the same results as the previous one. Participation in international trials for emerging treatment for sickle cell disease. I'm really very proud by my team, me and my team, Dr. Mona Taghi, Dr. Mona Gamrawi, and all other team, Dr. Nagwa, Dr. All of them are participating with me in international trial for emerging treatment for sickle cell disease. Phase 3 randomized trials of oxygenometer in sickle cell disease, Alexandria, Dr. Rona Hassab, as well as her center was in this trial as well, which show very good results. And this is, has been published in New England Journal of Medicine, which has a high impact factor over 70. Another study, dose escalation for the butyrate, but actually this is not completed. And now we have the new insights into the pathophysiology and development of novel therapies for sickle cell disease. They are looking to every pathophysiology in sickle cell disease and they are tackling everyone by a new drug. And this is actually what Professor Dr. Mervat Matar is going to present to you and to present the new medication of Novartis for sickle cell disease, which gives a very good result and FDA approved as well. So my conclusion, programs for sickle cell disease prevention should be done in the oases of the Western Desert of Egypt for the high carrier rate and the newly born cases. Hydroxyurea has a good impact on the management of sickle cell disease. New medications for treatment of the different pathological aspects of sickle cell disease are emerging, giving a good hope for patients. But gene therapy and gene editing by CRISPR-9, editing in severe cases of sickle cell disease, can have a positive impact in the life of these patients. And thank you all for attending.